There was a book that came out a number of years ago. It was a very good book called The Trellis and the Vine. So you know, if you're into gardening, you have a trellis, that sort of lattice work thing, and then you have a vine that needs to grow on the trellis. That's how you get fruit from the vine. It needs to have something to grow on. So the argument in the book is that a church is both trellis and vine. And you need a trellis. You need people to balance the books. You need people to make sure that the air conditioning works and the lights are on. So the trellis matters. But the point of the trellis is not to have a trellis. Not to say, hey, everyone, come look. I got a trellis. Come to my garden. There it is. Beautiful. What are you doing with it? I just look at it. It's a great trellis. The whole point of a trellis is that something grows on it. So the aim is not to get 1,000 of you maintaining the trellis. People got those gifts. People need to do it. We're very thankful for them. The aim is that there's enough trellis going on that all of you can be doing the vine ministry, the one another ministry, the relentless people ministry. Do you know you don't need your elders or your pastor's permission to love people, to invite someone into your home? You don't have to have a spotless home. You don't have to have a big home. You can have paper plates. You say, would you come over? You can take them out for coffee. What do? Ask them how you can pray for them. Read a book. Go through a book of the Bible. Now, I understand God has wired us all differently, and you can take the tests, and some of you are off the charts extroverts, and some of you had to do all you could to get the courage to come here this morning, and the fellowship hall or the lobby afterward is the worst part of the week. That's true for some people. It really is. We're all different places on that scale, and we have different gifts. But for each one of us, no matter our personality, God is calling us to a relentless focus on people. And so you come here on Sunday morning to hear the word, hopefully to be fed, all of that, but you come here to do ministry too. We don't want to be as Marlin said to Dory in Finding Nemo, of course I like you. It's because I like you, I don't want to spend time with you. It's a complicated emotion. Even if you come just thinking, maybe there's just one person you need to talk to. One person you just want to say, how's your week? One person maybe you just think, I'm going to meet one person I haven't met before, or I'm going to ask one person how I can pray for them. Focus on people, because you love people and you like people. What will we see in a church like this that stands together, that grows together, that likes to be together? I think you will see smiles, and you'll see tears, and hugs, and laughter. And there will be notes, and there will be a hand on the shoulder, and there will be meals, and there will be heads bowed together in the Bible and prayer as we strive in God's grace to be a godly people and a Bible people and a one another people.